offer.
It's 3:18 in the morning time, and I've got some Darlene Dalton for all you long-haul drivers out there. And brother, if you're driving across the Lone Star State, you got one heck of a long haul.
Thanks for pulling over. My car just died on me, and I don't know what to do.
I'd be glad to have a look at it for you.
Oh, gosh, would you? I'd be so grateful. I just don't know what's wrong with it. But let me show you what it does.
All right.
I'll get it for you.
Oh, damn. There it goes again.
Like you got carburetor trouble. No, there's nothing I can do to fix that. Be glad to give you a ride in the nearest gas station.
Well, I don't know.
Suit yourself. It's late, you know. Could be out here all night. I could just make a phone call for you.
Well, if it won't cause you too much trouble, I'll go ahead and catch a ride to the first open gas station or whatever. Looks like you've been on the road for quite a while.
Yes, ma'am, I have.
So have I. I left Chicago yesterday morning. Been driving ever since. I'm moving to San Antonio. I start a new job there next Wednesday. Look If you'll just let me out here, I can walk over to that place. My boyfriend and I are planning to be married in 3 months. Please. I'll give you money. I'll give you anything. And I promise I won't say a word to anyone. Please. Just let me go.
Okay. Sorry I took you so far out of your way. It's just that I was kind of hoping maybe, you know, I'll take you back to that place.
No. Look, just let me out of here.
All right.
Anything.
Listen, Hawkins, I've been patient so far, and I'd hate like hell to get tough with you, but the only way this is going to work is if you cooperate with us. And one way or another, you will cooperate. Who was she? Did you know her? Okay, look, if you don't want to talk about her, why don't you tell me about some of the others? Look, I am sick of playing around with you. I want to know about the girl, Hawkins.
Now. I want an answer from you, Hawkins. You know, I could rough up a sorry like you in a big hurry. Maybe then you'd have something to tell me.
What do you think, Will?
You think you're a real tough guy, don't you?
Not gonna get anything out of him that way. Why don't you boys get yourselves a cup of coffee? You can take those things off of him. Get us a couple cheeseburgers and fries. You like chocolate shakes?
Yes, sir.
Get us a couple large.
Okay.
Go ahead and have one. That's what they're there for. My name's Gaines. What do you go by? Daniel? Daniel Ray?
Don't make no difference.
Well, Daniel, I thought you wanted to talk to us. Isn't that what you told the judge during your arraignment? Well, you gonna talk to me or not?
I'll talk to you. Not to the rest of them. I ain't talking to nobody that's gonna treat me bad.
Fair enough. So, Daniel, let's start over again. They read you the rights, didn't they?
Yes, sir.
You want me to get you a lawyer?
Don't need one.
Okay. So, what's this you told the judge about killing all these other people?
It's true. I did.
You said there were 50, I think. Do you really mean that?
Yes, sir. Gonna be more, probably. Maybe 100.
Well, Daniel, that's a whole lot of people. Just when did you do all that?
Just all the time.
Do you remember the first person you ever killed?
Yes, sir.
Who was it?
I don't know. Never asked her name, nothing.
When did it happen?
20-some-odd years ago.
How old were you?
About 15. Went down to where the whores was. Never had done anything like that before, but I knew where they was because I seen something about all of them together the way they was that I didn't like. So I kept going. Then I saw this one look real good starting to leave. Got out of the car and followed her. She stopped when she heard me following her and asked me what I want. I couldn't say nothing to her. It's kind of like I was scared. She knows the whole time what I want, but she just laughs and called me a creep she didn't want to touch. Next thing I know, I pick up this stick and start for her. It's like something inside just pushing me. And then she stopped moving and I knew she was ready. But she made so much noise I was scared, so I ran. Back to my car and left. It was real exciting to me.
Do you know for a fact you killed her?
Yeah, pretty sure.
Where?
Scranton.
Scranton, Pennsylvania.
Yeah.
Remember when? The date?
Be 1960. July, I think it was.
Well, that's all right, we'll check it out. Did you tell anybody else about this?
No, I just went home and never said anything about it.
Who lived with you at home?
Mother and sister.
No father?
Yeah.
What?
I was just thinking back about all that.
Why don't you tell me about it?
Hurt in the war, so he'd be with us all the time. I can remember Mom bringing in roughnecks and oil fields. I could tell Daddy was different when they was there. Sex with him right there in front of us.
And you figure that's why you kill, huh?
Something like that. Anyways, I don't want to talk about it.
What do you want to talk about?
Well, I was thinking about this little gal. Picked up about 6 years ago. Right around here.
Who was she?
I don't know, just some hitchhiker. I had this favorite cruising spot. Them college girls would get out hitchhiking at night and get stuck a lot of times.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm heading towards Corpus.
Oh, great.
I'll have to get that for you. Sometimes this old door is kind of stubborn. There it is.
Thanks anyway, but I have changed my mind. It's so late and I'm really tired. I think I'm just gonna go on back and spend the night in Waco. Oh God, no!
Thank you.
Yeah, I never had no trouble with any hitchhiker except that one time. Once they was in my car, they was mine.
Yeah, come in.
Sheriff, I've got your hamburgers.
Yeah, just set them down. I'll be back in just a minute. Get on the horn and get Doc Spivey over here. I want him to see some of this.
You think he's certifiable?
I don't know about this one. You've told me now about several women you picked up, but so far only one of them's gotten away.
There were others.
Then I'm curious about something. How come you never got called for any of them?
Well, that's easy. I stuck to the highways. Hell, one year I put nearly 60,000 miles on one car. Sure, they might have got away, but I was long gone by the time they got to any policeman. That reminds me of this one time. It was somewhere, Louisiana, I think. I remember I was drinking pretty good that night.
A guy and a girl comes out of this bar. It's late and is having words. And the guy takes off, leaving her all alone.
Want a ride?
Sure didn't figure her for no trouble. She was drunk, didn't even seem to care where we was going.
So where are we headed, cowboy?
I don't know. Want a beer?
No. I got what I want right here. Want some?
Tell you what, I don't approve of that.
Well, that's your problem, ain't it?
This whore really made me mad. Her foul language and tough acting.
Nice magazine. Hey, thanks for the ride. You can just let me out right up here. I need to call a friend. My boyfriend. Look, you better pull over, because I'm going to get sick.
Oh, yeah? Go ahead.
I said pull over, and I mean it.
Okay. Hold on a minute. I'll have to open that for you.
You just hold on. You just get out and leave it running.
Come on, I didn't mean nothing.
Do it now. Go on, move back.
I didn't mean to cause no trouble.
Daniel, what's Moon's last name?
Luton.
What?
Luton. Moon Luton. Won't do you no good, though. He's already captured in Louisiana.
Whereabouts?
I don't know. Just something I heard. Maybe Baton Rouge.
So, where do you know this Moon Luton from?
I met Moon maybe 5-6 years ago. We was working for a moving company.
Furniture moving?
Yeah. Me and him started working off the same truck.
It checks out. Baton Rouge PD is holding one Moon Luton, charged with grand theft auto and involuntary manslaughter. They're interested in what we've got.
Tell them we'll get back to them.
So, tell me some more about you and this Moon Luton.
I hear about when we first started running through this area.
Yeah, that'll be fine.
Started one morning during a job. We was moving this old woman in Rockdale, up north of here.
Easy.
All right, all right.
Boy, I don't like it.
He was trying pretty hard to get on my good side, you know. I knew what he was after. Then I saw this good-looking hide next door, alone. Right away, I start thinking about paying her a visit later on.
Yes, I remember you.
Well, Miss Rogers just happened to mention that your air conditioner was broke. Well, anyways, we thought we'd be glad to have a look at it for you. Only charge you $20, and that's if we get it running.
Well, I don't know. It's awful late and all.
Well, yes, ma'am. We just got through, but I figured it being so hot and all, you probably want it fixed. Tell you what, we'll only charge you $10. It won't take Moon here but a few minutes to get it going. Guaranteed you can't get it fixed nowhere cheaper.
Well, okay. I sure wouldn't mind some AC for a change. It's a windy unit back there in my bedroom.
Uh-huh.
down at the end of the hall. Would you like something to drink?
No, thank you.
My name is Karen Grimes, by the way.
Yeah.
You know, I've actually been meaning to get that thing fixed for some time now. I really do appreciate this.
Yeah. Sure look good today.
What?
Like the way you look. You know, when you was out there trimming them bushes.
Thank you. I think I'll go check on you.
Sure, I'll have it fixed in a minute.
Case file on Grimes, will you? Oh, it's a missing person, 1979, I think.
78.
Go ahead. So, what did you do with the body?
Dumped it south of town.
Whereabouts?
I don't know exactly.
Do you remember the address of where any of this taking place?
No, sir. This is our first trip here in the town.
All of a sudden, your memory for details isn't as sharp. How come?
Well, you see, we was pretty messed up most of the time. We'd get up and start drinking. There'd be pills. You know, I have a hard time handling some of that stuff. I could probably find her if I looked for her.
Which one of these is Karen Grimes?
I don't recognize her.
Well, Daniel, I'm having one big problem with this. Everything you've been telling us, for the most part, has been in a newspaper. Now, I want to believe you, but I've got to have more.
I ain't lying. It's the truth.
All right. I want to hear exactly what you did with the body.
Well, like I said, we went south on 35.
Wait a minute, Daniel. Why don't you draw some maps?
Okay. So we was going south on 35. I guess we went about 10 miles or so. Saw this sign for some creek. Thought that'd be a good place. Drove on around to the other side. East, I'm pretty sure. Drove back that direction a little ways and then turned into this gravel road right before the bridge. Went back a ways till we couldn't be seen from the road. Stopped there. Drug her over to these bushes right near the creek. That's where we left her.
One last thing. Do you think you could ever change?
I just don't know. Seems like killing for me is just like breathing for everybody else. Just can't live without doing it all the time.
All right, Daniel. I think that about does it for now. Thank you.
Well, Doc?
I just don't know. You and I and every other normal person say he's a lunatic. But in the eyes of the law...
We've cleared 6 murder cases in this area so far. 9 more around the state, 27 others from outside. And now, the Canadians want to talk to him and his sidekick.
Well, he's pretty much of a textbook example. No father to speak of. The mother you already know about. 3rd grade education. He has violent hostilities for women.
Look, Doc, I know the guy's crazy. I'm going to leave that crap up to the court. What I want to know at this point is, can we believe this nut? Hell, he's saying he's killed over 200 people.
Well, I just don't know. He's a consummate liar. He mixes lies with the truth. Maybe he has. But then again, I've got to have more time with him.
He's been in jail twice before. And I'll be damned they turned him loose both times. Thanks, Doc. Daniel, how'd you like to take a little ride with me tomorrow? Might help you remember a few things.
Yes, sir. I'd like to. Think it'll help this investigation.
This is it, huh?
No, sir, this isn't it.
This is what you drew on your map.
Yeah, but it ain't right. For one thing, there weren't no fence over there. It's further on up the road back yonder.
Okay.
Now, you think it's down this way, right?
Yeah, right up there.
Okay.
There it is, right up there.
Yeah.
Right there.
We gonna go out again tomorrow?
I don't know. That kind of depends on you, Daniel, and how much help you are to us.
I'll do everything I can to help y'all. All I want to do is see these cases cleared up so the families of my victims can rest easy. If I can keep them young girls from hitchhiking, I know my life has important meaning after all.
Come on.
Baby doll, if it wasn't for these policemen here, you'd be mine.
You fellas ready to go?
Sure.
There used to be a store.
What are you talking about?
Right there. Used to be a 7-Eleven or something.
He's right. We had a call there one night.
Get us some of them magazines, too. Just don't depend on me for nothing.
Well, I mostly look at the pictures, but you could read some of that stuff out loud to me. You know, them letters and all.
Why don't you just get the kind that's just got the pictures?
They don't sell them at this kind of store.
Hell, I don't like wasting my time on them that don't show nothing.
Yeah, them others are better. Hey, I wish we could make our own X-rated magazines.
Yeah, I bet that would look pretty good.
Hey.
How you boys doing tonight?
Fine, just real fine.
Is that gonna be all?
Yeah.
You got any money, Moon? Left my wallet out in the car.
No, I ain't got none.
That'll be $52.19.
Don't worry about it none, Daniel.
I'll take care of it.
Oh, no! No!
What? Hey, how about we make some pictures for our magazine?
Get some of this other stuff.
Daniel, it's important you tell us about anything else like this.
Yes, sir. I just didn't think about them in that last deal. You think these will help you a whole lot?
I think they'll be very helpful to us. Why did you leave them in the bus station?
We just ended up being there a whole bunch. Mainly it'll be Molly's idea. One time we was real low on money, so Moon got a hold of his sister. She was pretty young, really just a kid. She was real experienced and smart.
Molly, girl, where'd you get all this?
Working.
Where?
You know.
Yeah, you're gonna catch a disease in that place.
Yeah, well, even if I do and it rots my brain, I'll never be as stupid as you are.
You better watch your tongue, girl, or you're gonna be headed right back to that whorehouse.
It's not a whorehouse, it's a massage parlor.
What are you talking about? I thought she was heading back.
Moon said I could stay with y'all.
Yeah?
Yeah. Look, I'm the one who bailed y'all out. Don't give me any of this little girl.
What do you think?
Well, I guess it don't bother me none. Of course, we ain't making no money or nothing.
What have y'all been up to, huh? I know what you've been up to. I'll show you how to make some real money at it. Come on. Let's go down to the bus station.
How come?
You will see.
Stations. She showed us how to use lockers for keeping stuff in.
It only cost a quarter for as long as you want. That way, we didn't have to carry so much in the car.
Well, what do you think?
Man, I thought he was coming for us. Well, looky here.
This here's Jasmine. She just split up with her sugar dad. Not for it, Jasmine. I told her she could ride with us a ways. Honey? Jasmine says she'll be glad to pay for the ride. She says she knows how to please. Any way you want it.
What kind of killings was Molly involved in?
I don't know exactly. Be a bunch over the last couple of years.
It didn't bother Moon to have his sister involved in all these killings?
No, he liked it. They got her to making meals when they needed making. Besides, she was a lot better than us at pickups.
How did you get along with her?
Real good. We was married, you know.
When did this happen?
About a year ago. We just did it ourselves, didn't have no preacher or nothing.
I see. So what effect did this have on the relation you had with Moon?
Oh, we was fine. Kind of funny thinking about being related and all. Besides, me and Molly had a normal relationship. There weren't no sex involved.
Oh, thanks, Gusenberry. That's okay, I got it.
Now, Daniel, what we have here are unsolved murder and missing persons cases. Dating as far back as 9 years ago. They are not all just in Texas. They're from all over the country.
You want me to show you mine?
Yes. I'd like for you to very carefully look at these. If you see anything you recognize, let me know.
Okay. Mm-mm. No. This one we did. This is one we did. Up in Illinois, by a lake somewhere. It was one of my favorite tricks on her. I'd go someplace real crowded, find the best looking hide I could, tell them I needed help because of a broken arm. I had this thing I'd wear on my arm, you know, a sling. Just about always they'd fall for it. Once they got in the car to go with me, had to move kind of fast, as they could figure things out pretty quick. It was too late by then. I already know about this one.
Which one?
You know, the one up in Utah. You know, I told you about carrying her body with me to South Carolina.
Wait a minute. I'm sorry. I'm getting kind of confused. Is this the school teacher that you abducted in the shopping mall?
Yeah.
All right.
I know this one. This is one of mine. We gotta get moving.
What?
Come on, we slept late. All the cars are gone.
So what are we gonna do?
Same thing. It's just harder in the daylight.
We shouldn't have let Moon take the car.
That ain't no problem. We just act like hitchhikers.
And then what?
They kill them and take their car. Real simple.
One eye should get us the ride while you hide out.
Yeah. Here, use this as soon as you get in the car. Make sure nobody's around.
I'll take it.
You a preacher?
No. Doctor. Krivix is my name.
I'll get that.
Oh, well, thanks very much.
Doc, when we get through here, can I get a ride? Me and my wife? We'll go in your direction.
Absolutely. You got yourself a deal. Hi there, young lady.
Hi. How are you?
Fine. How are you today?
Just fine, thank you.
You know, when something like this happens, usually there's nobody around. I guess the good Lord was watching over me today. Knew I needed you people to give me a hand.
Doc, you got something dripping under here.
Let me take a look at it.
Right down there.
Aren't as good as they used to be. I don't see a thing.
I'm sure it's all right. I'm sure it's nothing important. You can go on the way it is now and look at it later.
Where are you all headed?
Oh, anywhere we can find an honest day's work.
How long you been on the road, young lady?
I don't know. For a while now.
Well, you know, I might have an idea. You know, along with my practice, well, I've got this kind of appliance repair business. When I started out, I did all the work myself. But now I hire a man to do the work. I don't know if it's anything you might be interested in or not, but my handyman quit the other day. I need somebody that work real well with tools.
Yeah?
And plenty of work in the office. Something you could help with. So, you think that's something you might be interested in?
Maybe. Just kind of depends.
Well, it doesn't pay much, but there's a real nice apartment that goes with it. It's all part of the deal.
Is this how this goes in here?
No, not exactly. You got to get it all the way up here. If you don't, you never get the trunk lid down. Goes right on up in there, and then it fastens on the bottom there. There you go, that's the way it is. Come on in. I'll show you the shop and introduce you to my secretary. Come on, come on.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Oh, yes.
Hi, Doris. I'm back. Mm-hmm. You see, I laid all this out when I built it. All the heavy appliances over here in this wall, see? And then anything you can handle with your hands are on these shelves over here.
Honey, I've got to go now. We've got a customer coming. Okay. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Millie Perkins says she has to have her dryer back tomorrow.
Oh, I'll take care of Millie Perkins later. Doris, I want you to meet Molly and Daniel Smith. They're going to be working with us.
Oh, how nice.
Yeah, they're going to be living in the garage apartment. Come on, I'll show it to you. Of course, you'll be spending most of your time here, but the clinic is right through here. Come on.
Oh, Dr. Crivix.
Yes, what is it?
May I have a word with you in private?
Go ahead, I'll be right with you. What is it, Doris?
Dr. Crivix, where did you find those two?
I picked them up on the highway.
What do you know about them?
I don't think we should stay around here. It's a bad idea.
Don't you worry none about her. We can fix that. Come on, let's see what this place looks like.
Jesus Christ, who the hell are you?
Oh, there you are. Have you all met each other?
Hardly. Let me guess. The new repairman? Damn it.
You'll have to excuse my daughter. I'm afraid college has made her forget her upbringing.
Here. You want to repair something? Fix this.
Excuse me. Monica! Now listen, darling. These people are going to be working with us, and you're going to have to learn to start treating them decently. You understand?
Okay, Daddy.
I know it doesn't look like much now, but with a little work.
Yeah, we can fix it up.
What about Moon?
Oh, yeah. Our brother Moon usually stays with us. We got to kind of figure on having him here, too.
Well, know about that.
He's a real hard worker.
He's a Christian, too.
Well, okay. We can try it out and see how it works. I'll leave you all alone for a while. Later on, I'll show you the clinic.
Bye, Dad. I'll see you later.
So long. Don't be late.
That old man asked me if I was God-fearing this morning.
What'd you say?
I didn't know what to say. And I just told him that, as far as I'm concerned, Sunday's a day of rest.
That's good. Because you're supposed to be a churchgoer.
What? What is this?
Don't worry about it, none. You should have been a preacher instead of a doctor.
I know.
Keep that bottle down. Hook up some more patients. Let's go somewhere.
I'm ready.
Don't you think it's time we got ourselves a new car?
Hell yeah. I can't find 287 on here. What color would it be?
Hell, man, you ain't looking in the right place. It's over there.
Let's play the game.
Is the coast clear?
Hell, yeah.
Good night, baby. Say good night. I'm going to bed.
Good night, Daddy. Einstein's theory forecast two television Americas, with one of them, cable America, becoming too big for advertisers to ignore. Advertisers need cable to reach these cable Americans who are watching more cable.
Looks like I'll be driving in style here in about a week.
What the hell are you talking about?
Hell, boy, I'm gone next paycheck.
What for?
I don't like this working around here. I like the way we was going on before. Hey, girl.
Hey. Where y'all been?
Getting a new car.
Ew-wee, where'd you get that?
From her?
What are you gonna do?
Privick's repair shop. Oh, hi, Pauline. Oh, sure. I'll just have our men come over and pick it up at your place. Uh-huh. Okay, bye. Daniel, you'll need to get over this address and pick up Miss Johnson's refrigerator.
Why can't we just fix it there?
Because you can't. You'll need some help. It's heavy.
Come on, man.
These are all the people that haven't paid their bills.
I'll do something about her real soon.
Hey, there's your girlfriend.
Mrs. Johnson is waiting.
Come on, let's go.
Can I give you that address?
No. No, we didn't forget the toolkit. Thank you.
out and grab a hamburger or something.
Have you seen Doris around? I've looked all over for her.
I wish you wouldn't do this. I tell you, it ain't gonna be no big problem. Her cut up in that field and all, buzzards will take care of it.
I'll see you in a few months, maybe. I'm going on back down them swamps for a while.
We gone.
This small stuff stacked up in these piles. When you get through that, I'd like to have you trim that hedge over there. And then break up all this clippings and stacked up in these piles.
Daddy, there's an emergency call in here.
I'll be right back. Daughter, you shouldn't be out here dressed like that. I'll be at Holy Redemption Hospital until tomorrow night in case you need me.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Be careful driving.
Yeah.
Invite you over here, but it's just that I don't like being around these slime balls that Daddy hired. Okay. Okay, great. Well, listen, I'm just gonna jump in the shower and then I'll be right on over. Okay. Okay, good. Thanks. Bye-bye.
Excuse me, ma'am. I didn't mean to frighten you. It's just that I've been here the last few minutes asking your help out here. A few questions, and I thought you'd like to know.
Oh, well, that's okay. But I was just getting ready to leave.
Well, that's all right. I can talk to them out here in the driveway.
You don't suspect them of anything, do you?
It's just routine in the case of a missing person. We did have a call from authorities in Baton Rouge about someone by the name of Moon Luton.
Yeah, he used to work here up until a few days ago.
Yes, ma'am, that's what we understand, and that's why I wanted to have a few words with your father's employees.
Okay, go ahead. I'm going to go ahead and go.
Thank you, ma'am. Yes, sir, I understand your brother left here about a week ago.
Yeah, it was about a week ago.
And where did he head out to?
He went back where we were.
I think you'll be hearing from the brother at all.
Yeah.
I see your driver's license, please?
I don't have it with me.
Freeze! What are you reaching for?
My wallet.
Put your hands where I can see them. Would you step out of the car, please? Wallet, huh?
Moon about that. Sheriff, you suppose I could get me another chocolate milkshake?